Today we got an up-close look at the sunken barge carrying an excavator in Lee County. It fell into the Gulf of Mexico Monday night during a strong storm. These are new pictures from our crew who went out in a boat today to get that look. There is concern that gas and oil inside could leak into the Gulf of Mexico. NBC2's Lucas Seiler is live right now at Delnor-Wiggins Pass State Park. Lucas, any sign of oil in the water there?
Divers did go underwater earlier this afternoon to make sure that the excavator was not leaking any oil, to make sure that it was not contaminating the water. It is not as of right now. And you can tell just how windy it is out here. It has really been making this situation very difficult for workers out here who are under a lot of pressure to get this job done after the Army Corps of Engineers ordered them to remove it as quickly as possible.
Racing against choppy waters, this salvage team has only limited time to make sure this situation doesn't become even worse.
Unfortunate. It's unfortunate.
With high tide creeping up and as bad as it looks on the surface, the biggest problem of all sits right below these waves.
I hear there's oil on board, as long as they don't spill that or dump that all over the shore.
And that is a concern because of the wildlife. I mean, that's the beauty of this beach at Delnor-Wiggins.
A company called Quality Enterprises of Naples has been busy dredging Wiggins Pass. Workers docked it overnight Monday, but the barge toppled over, sending the equipment into the water during a storm.
That thing hasn't got away yet on them.
It's a project directors wanted to wrap up in time for seasonal visitors like Diane Devine. Now it is delayed weeks.
They were busy a couple days ago, just busy all day long, and now they're scrambling to rescue the equipment.
Quality Enterprises did not return our calls today, but the U.S. Coast Guard tells NBC2 Kelly Brothers has been hired to remove it. While they develop a plan, CETO is busy with yet another problem, tugging the front of the barge that's stuck on shore.
I'm thinking sure it's going to take quite a while to get her done.
We also found out that on top of this project, CETO has been very busy working on getting three other sunken boats out of the Gulf of Mexico after very strong rain events the last few days. It's important to mention that there is no perimeter around this accident site. There hasn't been one all day. There isn't one now. I'm working to find out why. Also, the company that is in charge of this dredging project, I'm told, will not face charges as of yet. Live in Naples, Lucas Seiler, NBC2.